Safer EHRs, an introduction to the Safer Guides.
You always love to get the call at 7 in the morning from the first person that comes in to start the day, and the system does not come up. It's never easy, it's never fun.
If there's one thing in medicine, it's the unexpected. So you do get trained to expect the unexpected.
When you're working in an EHR environment, you are used to a downtime. And normally from our EHR system, it would be related to an issue with the database. And we know how to handle that. This was very unusual circumstance. We had two types of downtime. We have a system that's unavailable because the application is broken, because the server failed during backup process. So we are able to deal with that. And then, who would think that you have to go through the process of figuring out how to rebuild the previous 24 hours worth of data? Most people don't ever anticipate that a backup process fails. The backup is the backup. How does that fail? But it does.
In medicine, we're trained to expect the unexpected. The key is to be prepared. But EHR implementation presents a new set of challenges. Systems that run perfectly in demos, in reality, do not. And we have to change how we work in order to use EHRs well, because it's very inefficient to simply put an EHR on top of an existing routine. EHRs introduce the potential for safety risks in ways we haven't been trained to anticipate. The Safer Guides are self-assessment tools to help you and your team identify these risks and mitigate them. SAFER stands for Safety Assurance Factors for EHR Resilience. There are 9 SAFER guides available on the healthit.gov website. Each guide is a self-assessment checklist which identifies your organization's level of implementation according to a set of evidence-based recommended practices for safe EHR implementation. By completing the checklist, you and your team can identify places where your EHR implementation is vulnerable to EHR-related patient safety risks. You can then save the checklist, email the saved document to your team, or print it out. A partially completed checklist can be handed off to another team member for additional assessment. It's likely that an assessment will reveal more than one safety risk, and of course, your organization can't deal with everything at once. By rating the status of each recommended practice, the checklist helps you prioritize and decide what to do first. The checklist in each guide contains recommended practices for EHR safety at each stage of EHR implementation and use. Sometimes one person completes the checklist using the fillable circles to record the current implementation status. This might be the office manager or risk manager. In other organizations, a team may complete the checklist, working as a group, or handing off the partially completed document to one another. Here's how it works. Let's say the office manager decides to do a self-assessment using the Contingency Planning Guide. She quickly looks over the explanation of the SAFER concept and description of the guide topic, then goes directly to the checklist. The first recommended practice is hardware that runs applications critical to the organization's operation is duplicated. But she asks herself, what does that mean? How can I tell if this is fully, partially, or not implemented at all? So she clicks on the link to the worksheet. She reads the rationale for the recommended practice. If the rationale provides enough information at this point, she can use the implementation status drop-down list to rate the organization's level of implementation of the recommended practice. But if she's still not sure, suggested sources of input shows people she may need to consult in order to make this assessment. Examples and scenarios help clarify the questions that need to be asked, such as, who will know if there's a remotely located warm site? The sources of input will direct her to the type of staff who will know what a warm site is. In the assessment notes area, she begins to list questions and possible action steps to complete the assessment and subsequently to improve the organization's practices. Call vendor. Who will know about backup procedures? She can use the team worksheet to assemble the team needed to answer key questions about each recommended practice. Other guide features provide background about EHR implementation and safety, information about the guide, and suggestions how to use it. And because this is an interactive PDF form, it includes bookmarks, links, and drop-down lists to make it easy to use, share, collaborate on, and create a fresh copy for later reassessment.
If we had actually had the SAFER guide at the time of the EMR implementation, we could have potentially foreseen some of the issues that we had.
When we read the term warm site backup, we actually had no clue as to what that meant. I'm not an IT professional, and the IT team is not a clinical department. So it really emphasizes when you start coming across terms, warm site backup, and terms like that, it takes a team to thoroughly go through this process.
We're actually using the SAFER guide now to help plan the next evolution of our electronic medical record system.
To download your copy of the SAFER guides, go to www.healthit.gov/safer guide.